Reelected Senator Risa Hontiveros officially becomes the next leader of the opposition as she took her oath before outgoing Vice President Leni Robredo. Our correspondent Adrian Ayalin now joins us with an update. Adrian, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, Senator Risa Hontiveros will now have to take on an active role in the opposition after Vice President Leni Robredo administered her oath of office as reelected senator here at the office of the Vice President this morning. In her message, VP Leni noted that Hontiveros, who ran under Akbayan Party, is now the highest elected official from the opposition. Hontiveros was accompanied by her three daughters during the oath taking. The Vice President also stated that as soon as the result of the 2022 presidential elections became clearer, she immediately texted Hontiveros, telling her that she is now their leader. Hontiveros, for her part, said that she will continue her advocacies at the Senate, including efforts on COVID-19 response as well as other health initiatives. But she also stressed that she will continue the fight against false information and the fight for constitutionally guaranteed freedoms such as freedom of expression, of assembly, and of the press. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Adrian Ayalin there joining us on the line. Back here in the newsroom, detained opposition Senator Laila De Lima begins her road to recovery after undergoing major surgery. In a message to media, De Lima said she is feeling fine but is still experiencing some pains. The 62-year-old lawmaker had an operation to remove part of her uterus. She's now back at the Philippine National Police Custodial Center in Camp Crame. De Lima has been in jail since 2017 over illegal drug charges. Her lawyers believe the two remaining cases against her should be dismissed after key witnesses recanted their testimonies. Vice President Leni Robredo looking back at her journey over the last 6 years as she prepares to step down from her post. In the final episode of her Sunday radio program, Robredo said her political differences with President Duterte was a blessing in disguise for her team. Robredo has been a favorite target of the president and his allies. For a time, she held the positions of Housing Secretary and co-chairperson of the Interagency Committee on Anti-Illegal Drugs, but she eventually quit due to policy differences.
Yung lahat na mga kahirapan na binigay sa amin, actually, yun yung nagpahusay sa amin. Dahil hindi kami tinuring nakakampi, hindi kami tinuring na bahagi ng pamahalaan. Natuto kami ka, Ellie. Natuto kami na maghanap ng paraan. At to my mind, yun yung nagpahusay sa amin. Kasi pag mahirap, nagiging mahusay ka eh. Pag mahirap, naghahanap ka ng paraan. Kasi ita namin na yung power ng private partnerships na kapalaki. At ngayon, kaya malakas yung loob namin gawin yung angat buhay. Kasi nahasa na kami. Nahasa kami sa ganun na trabaho na halos walang tulong from government. Pero marami nagagawa.
Robredo's team is busy organizing the souvenirs given to her on the campaign trail. Robredo ran for president in the May 2022 elections but lost.
Ang dami, sobrang gaganda. Humingi ako ng parang permission ng mga nagbigay na i-donate ko lahat na paintings for Angat Buhay. I-donate ko yung lahat na paintings sa Angat Buhay para maraming makinaba sa mga unang gagawin. Parang exhibit nitong mga lahat na, yung mga exhibit ng mga paintings, pero gagawin din siyang fundraising event. Yung mechanics, abangan na lang nila, ilalabas namin yung mechanics this week. At ito pa yung magiging seed fund para sa ating mga activities. So sana okay lang sa mga, sana okay lang sa mga nagbigay. Properly acknowledge po yung mga nagbigay. Malaki lang akong bahay, hindi ko to papakawalan ka, Eddie, pero wala talagang paglalagyan. Napaka-heartbreaking na bitawan yung iba, pero ito, tingin kasi namin ka, Eddie, ito yung best way.
Robredo has announced that the Angat Buhay program will be launched as a non-government organization next month.